to all of my comic book historians. Dante D here, and welcome to the channel where we talk about comic books and other geek stuff. In this video today, we are going to be talking about the different eras and the different ages of comic books, and when they started and when they ended. So for those of you that are new to collecting comic books, different comic book eras are split up into different ages. They are the Golden Age of Comics, the Silver Age of Comics, the Bronze Age of Comics, the Copper Age of Comics, and of course, the Modern Age of Comics. Now there's a lot of debate and discussion among comic book collectors if the Copper Age is an appropriate term to use for that era in comic books. And also there is a lot of debate and discussion over when these eras started or ended, especially with the Bronze Age and the Copper Age, which is what I call it, of comics. So let's start off with the Golden Age of Comics. When did the Golden Age of Comics actually start? And for those of you that know a little bit about comic books, you probably will know that the Golden Age of comic books started with the publication of Action Comics number 1, which is the first appearance of Superman. Action Comics number 1 is essentially what started the whole comic book craze. Superman is also the progenitor of the superhero trope and is what made the whole concept of superheroes relevant in pop culture. Before Action Comics number 1, comic books did exist. They were mostly just reprints of comics that appeared in newspapers. After we saw Superman, he got a whole lot of company. We got Batman, Wonder Woman, and a bunch of other superheroes, many of which don't even exist nowadays. The Golden Age of comics was known for superheroes in the first half of the Golden Age, but it really was World War II that stimulated the sales of superhero comic books and kept people interested in superheroes. America was at war and they were looking at their dreams and their fantasies and these heroes that could only exist in their imaginations to win the war for them. After the war, America really did not have any need for superheroes. Therefore, the popularity of them declined significantly to the point where the only heroes that survived were Batman, Superman, and Wonder Woman. It was mostly romance comics and horror comics and also crime comics that were really prominent in this age, and sci-fi comics as well, which were especially popular in the 1950s. Now, the Golden Age of comic books was actually a pretty long era. It lasted from 1938 all the way up to 1957, 1958. The official end of the Golden Age and beginning of the Silver Age started with Showcase number 4. This book is super expensive, of course, just like Action Comics number 1, but it is also super, super significant to comic book collectors, not only because this signified the beginning of the Silver Age of comic books, but also because this is what started the whole superhero revival. It was in the Silver Age that we saw a revival of superheroes and this new interest in them. DC brought back a lot of its characters that up until this point had been canceled, like Flash, Green Lantern, just to name a few, and Marvel. Oh boy, Marvel Comics. This was pretty much, to some collectors, the Marvel Age of comics, because Marvel created a whole whack of characters that were just cultural phenomena and continue to be so even in this day and age. The Silver Age gave us the Fantastic Four, the Incredible Hulk, Thor, Spider-Man, Iron Man, just to name a few. These are like big household names that came out of the Silver Age of comic books. So when did the Silver Age of comics end and when did the Bronze Age begin? This is very debatable and heavily discussed among comic book collectors, but I am of the mind, along with many others, that the Silver Age of comics ended and the Bronze Age began with Amazing Spider-Man number 121, which is the death of Gwen Stacy. The reason why this book is such a perfect point to signify a paradigm shift is because there is a death. Previous to Gwen Stacy dying, people didn't really die in comic books and stay dead. Marvel killed off Gwen Stacy and she stayed dead for a long time. This book here really signified a shift to darker stories in comic books and comic books being taken more seriously by older children teenagers, and adults. Now, the Bronze Age was just an exciting era for comic books. The Bronze Age of comics is my personal favorite era. Not only did we see so many awesome superhero comics coming out of this era, and so many new heroes also created during this era, but we also saw a revival of many genres that were kind of put to the side during the Silver Age because superheroes were so hot. Not to mention the fact that the Comics Code Authority, their rules were very stringent and really kind of limited what could be published in comic books. By the 70s, the rules of the Comics Code really kind of got more lax, thereby allowing publishers to experiment more with genres. So in the 70s and in the Bronze Age, we start seeing more sci-fi comics. Horror comics really became prominent again in the 1970s. Westerns, like you name it, there was probably a comic book for it. Now here's where things get a little bit divisive. After the Bronze Age, there are some collectors that believe that it is the modern age that began. This, and that is the age that we are still currently in with comic books. But I'm more of the mind that it was the copper age of comic books that followed the Bronze Age of comic books. And that is because what we see in the early 1990s is significantly different than what followed. The 1990s was a really crazy time in comic books, and I really think that it needs its own specific era. So I call that era the Copper Age of comics, and there are many collectors that actually do go along with that term. To me, the official end of the Bronze Age of comic books and the beginning of the Copper Age of comic books happened in 1986. That was a watershed year for comic books, not only because of The Dark Knight Returns and Watchmen, but also due to Crisis on Infinite Earths number 7. These three books here really signify that full shift to the darkest stories that we have ever seen in comic books up until this point. Dark Knight and Watchmen, and that cover of Superman holding the lifeless body of Supergirl. You had never seen this in comic books before. Comic books had never been this dark. This is when people really started to get a clue that, yeah, comic books are not for kids. They're actually mostly not for kids and more for adults. They started dealing with a lot of mature themes, and the stories became increasingly more complex. So what was going on in the Copper Age of comics? Not only were we getting really violent and dark stories, but people were also very, very interested in collecting comic books at this time. Not because they liked comic books, but they thought that they could get rich off of comic books. It wasn't uncommon around this time to see news stories and newspaper articles about comic books that were very rare, that were printed in the 1930s, selling for thousands and thousands of dollars. So for some reason, people got it in their minds that if they bought new comic books that were coming out that were significant, well then in a few years they'd be able to cash in and just get rich. Well, of course, this did not happen. And for those of you smart people out there, you probably know that everybody got the same idea and everybody went out to buy so many comic books and so many different copies of the same comic book. Well, publishers also caught on to this, and then they got increasingly greedy and they started publishing gimmicks to stimulate sales for certain comic books. You all remember those gimmicks. New number ones being published probably every single week. Characters dying, characters getting their back broken, special edition covers, holographic covers. Companies were just doing whatever they could to make the perceived collectability be higher for their books. Well, once people started trying to sell all these comic books, everybody else already had them, so they couldn't sell them, and they essentially ended up being worthless. Because of that, people stopped buying comic books, and the comic book market essentially crashed. Now, when does the Copper Age officially end and the modern age begin? That's really kind of tough to kind of pinpoint, and I think everyone is going to have a different opinion on this. I would really love to hear from you and when you think that the Copper Age of comics ended. For me, the end of the Copper Age of comics kind of coincided with the comic book crash that was associated with the collector's bubble that we saw in the early 1990s. If you really need a particular book that symbolizes that shift from the Copper Age to the modern age, I really think you can kind of look at two here. In my opinion, it could either be the death of Superman or Deathmate. Now, the death of Superman is actually a great story. I love it. It's probably one of my favorite Superman stories of all time. But for many, it embodies everything that was wrong with the 1990s and all of the gimmicks that we were seeing in the 1990s. The death of Superman is probably one of the most famous and most popular comic books of all time, just because of all of the media and news coverage that it got. People actually thought that this was it for the Man of Steel and he was going to be dead. Well, of course, they brought him back, and when everybody tried to sell those issues of the death of Superman, they couldn't because everyone else already had them and they weren't really worth much. Now, this also happened with Deathmate. Now, for those of you out there that don't know Deathmate is probably one of the worst comic books I've ever read in my life. This was supposed to be a universe crossover between Valiant Comics and Image Comics. Now, this comic book was just a piece of crap. Yeah, they had a lot of superstar artists working on it, but it had no plot. It was difficult to follow. I didn't understand what was going on. I've tried reading it multiple times, and I still don't really get what was going on. If there are any of you out there that understand what the heck happened in Deathmate, please let me know in the comics, because I certainly don't. Because of the price of this comic book and the delays, the numerous delays that happened with this comic book, people ended up just not caring. And all of these comic book stores ordered all of these copies thinking that it was going to sell really, really well. But at the end of the day, people just didn't care anymore and the market tanked. But that's just my opinion. What do you think was the official end of the Copper Age and the beginning of the modern age of comics? Would really love to hear from you below. And of course, now there's the modern age. And not many people have really made an effort to split up the era since 1993, 94, something odd. We've been in the modern age for almost 30 years now. I can't see the eras being split up any further. The modern age of comics, because it's been so long, there isn't really anything characteristic about it. But I'm sure many years from now, some comic book historians will sit down and probably split up the last 25 years or so of comic books into different eras. So that about does it for our video today. Really hope that you enjoyed it. Would really love to hear from you all. When do you think all of these eras began/ended? Because like I said, the opinions on this topic vary greatly in the comic book community. Would love to hear from you all. And as always, this is Dante D signing off. I will see you all in the next episode.